So, in the previous class, we have solved two problems on two spheres. So now further we'll solve problems on three spheres. Correct? So if you see the question, here they have given three spheres. Sphere number 1, sphere number 2 and sphere number 3. Right? The weight of all the three spheres is 1 kilonewton. Right? Then next, these two spheres, that is sphere number 2 and sphere number 3, they are connected by a cable AB. The length of this cable is 600 mm, and they have given radius of three spheres, that is radius is equal to 200 mm, they have given. So they have asked to calculate the reaction at contact surfaces. So if you see this sphere number 2, this is touching the horizontal surface, so reaction develops normal to the surface, that is vertical, right? So sphere number 2 is touching the sphere number 1, so here at this point reaction develops normal to the surface. So sphere number 3, this is touching the surface, normal to the surface, reaction develops. The sphere number 3, it is touching the horizontal surface, here the reaction develops. So therefore here four contact points we have. So therefore four reactions will be developed, as well as we have one cable which is attached to sphere 2 and 3. So here in this cable tension develops, so this has to be calculated. So as to solve this, first we will try to draw the free body diagram. So these are the three spheres, we will try to draw the free body diagram, right? If you see the sphere number 2, here it is being shown. So first is self weight. How the self weight is going to act? Always in downward direction. So weight of the sphere is 1 kilonewton. So 1 kilonewton weight, it is going to act in downward direction. Then next, this sphere is touching the horizontal surface, which is this horizontal surface, normal to the surface, reaction develops, which is vertical. So therefore reaction is developed vertical. So let us mark it as R2. So this is the contact surface between sphere 1 and sphere 2. Here the reaction develops, which is equal and opposite, which is equal and opposite, you can see. So which is being marked as R1, normal to the surface, reaction we have marked. Similarly, the free body diagram of sphere 1. So if you see sphere 1, we have, so self weight, it is going to act in downward direction. This is touching the surface here. So therefore here reaction R1 develops, this is touching the surface sphere 3, so therefore it is reaction R3, right? If you draw the free body diagram of this sphere 3, so self weight is going to act in downward direction. Then next way, this is touching this horizontal surface, so therefore here vertical reaction develops, that is R4. So this is attached with the sphere 2 with the help of cable. So here tension develops, that is tension AB, this is touching this sphere, so therefore equal and opposite, reaction develops, we can mark it as R3, correct? So this is the free body diagram of sphere 1, 2 and 3. So now we have to calculate these things. So before calculating, so first let us calculate this angle theta, at what angle this reaction R1 is inclined. So how we can calculate? We can take this angle A, B and another this center point you can take. So you can take somewhat like this A, B and C. As they have given center, the radius of the sphere is 200. So from here till here it is 200, from here till here it is 200. So therefore total length will be equal to 400 mm, right? And then next, this bottom length of AB is how much? 600. So I have to calculate this angle theta. So how do we calculate? Cos theta is equal to 400 divided by half of this 600, that is 300. Cos theta is equal to 300 by 400. If you do, you will get angle theta as 41.4 degrees. So R1 will be inclined at an angle of 41.4 with respect to horizontal, as well as this R3 is symmetric. So therefore R3 will also be inclined at an angle of 41.4 degrees. Correct. Next we will try to solve. So if you see this sphere 2, so here you can see 1, 2, 3 and 4 forces are acting on this sphere 2. So therefore we have 1, 2 and 3 unknowns we have. So therefore only two equations of equilibrium we have. So therefore we cannot solve this. So therefore we are not going to solve this first. If you see this pair, similarly here we have 1, 2, 3 and 4 forces we have. Out of that R4, TAB and R3, 3 unknowns we have. So therefore we cannot solve this also. And we will see this pair number 1. So 1, 2 and 3 forces which are acting on this pair 1. So if you see R1 and R3, 2 unknowns we have. So therefore we are going to solve this first. We will draw the free body diagram on this sphere 1. So here self weight 1 kN which is acting downwards is being shown here. R1 which is inclined at an angle of 41.4 which is being shown here. R3 we have, so R3 it is being shown here, which is acting at an angle of 41.4. So here we have three forces. So we will try to find out the reaction R1 and R3. So we can apply either Lamy's theorem or conditions of equilibrium. So let us apply the Lamy's theorem, right? So if you take this force R1, what Lamy's theorem says? Force divided by sine of angle between other two forces. So we'll take this R1, we have written R1 here, divided by sine of angle between other two forces. That is, other two forces means R3 and 1 kN. R3 and 1 kN. What is the angle between these two forces that has to be taken? That is 90 plus 41.4. So that will be equal to 131.4. Force divided by sine of angle between other two forces. So we'll take second force, that is R3 divided by sine of angle between other two forces, that is 90 plus 41.4, it is 131.4, that is R3 divided by sine 131.4. Next, third force will take 1 kN we have divided by sine of angle between other two forces, that is R1 and R3, that is 48.6 plus 48.6, that will be equal to 97.2 degrees. If you take R1 divided by sine 131.4 equal to 1 divided by sine 97.2. If you cross multiply, you will get value of R1 is equal to 0.756 kN. Similarly, if you solve this second equation, that is R3 by sine 131.4 equal to 1 by 97.2, you will get value of R3 is equal to 0.756. Next, we will try to see the free body diagram of sphere 2. So in the sphere 2, if you take reaction, we have R2 which is moving upwards, which is being shown here. 1 kN weight is acting in downward direction, which is being shown somewhere here. Next is, it is being attached to the cable TAB, which is being shown here. Next is the reaction R1, which is shown here, which is acting at an angle of 41.4 degrees. So here we have four forces now. So therefore we cannot apply Lamy's theorem. So we have to apply conditions of equilibrium, right? So as it is coplanar concurrent force system, we have two equations of equilibrium. That is f of x is equal to 0, f of y is equal to 0. We'll apply that. If you take f of x is equal to 0, all the forces has to be resolved along x direction and has to be equated to 0. So we'll take this f of x is equal to 0. First, this horizontal component we have, which is moving towards right, therefore positive, therefore it is plus TAB. This has to be resolved along x direction. If you see the arrow, it is going to move towards left, therefore minus. R1 is 0.756, we are going to resolve along the angle, therefore it is cos. So therefore it is 0.756 cos of angle, that is 41.4 degrees, that has to be equated to 0. So if you solve this, you will get value of TAB as 0.567 kN. Another equation we are going to take, summation of f of y is equal to 0. So we have to take this force R2 which is moving upwards, therefore plus R2 we have. Next is this R1 we have, this has to be resolved along y direction. If you see the arrow, if you resolve it, it is going to move downwards, therefore minus. R1 is 0.756,
and we are resolving away from the angle, so therefore it is sine of angle, that is 41.4. Third one is minus 1, as it is moving in downward direction, that is equal to 0. If you solve this equation, you will get value of R2 is equal to 1.5 kilonewtons. Next, we will try to solve this third sphere. So R2 will be equal to R4 as it is symmetrical. If you want to confirm it once, you can solve. So if you see 1 kilonewton, it is acting downwards, which is being shown here. R4 is acting upwards, which is being shown somewhere here. So here it is attached to the cable TAB, which is being shown here. Then next, this is the reaction R3 we have, which is being shown here, which is acting at an angle of 41.4. If you solve this by applying conditions of equilibrium, if you take f of y is equal to 0, you have to resolve. First one is you take R4, which is moving upwards, therefore plus R4. If you take this R3, it is, if you resolve along y direction, it is going to move in the downward direction, therefore minus 0.756. If you resolve away from the angle, that is sine of 41.4 degrees. This one is moving in downward direction, it is minus 1, that is equal to 0. R4 is equal to 1.5 kilonewton. If you see, R4 will be equal to R2 as it is symmetric. So therefore, this is equal to this. If you see this R1 and R3, it is symmetric. So therefore, R1 is equal to R3. So therefore, we have taken this R3 as 0.756. Thank you.